Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions about your world and my world. These first couple of questions are all about sleep. Wow, you guys really like sleep videos, huh? First question up, Dylan asks, Dear Blocko, why do we snore? Is there a bigger issue? Well, it's quite simple, really. People snore when they're having a really boring dream, or when I'm doing my stand-up routine. See, lights out. I'm still working on the jokes. But for real, Mayo Clinic defines snoring as the hoarse or harsh sound that occurs when air flows past relaxed tissues in your throat, causing the tissues to vibrate as you breathe. People can snore due to a variety of reasons. Allergies or a cold might do it, as well as alcohol consumption or sleep deprivation. A person's weight could also play a factor. Even just the anatomy of your mouth and sinuses could play a part. No matter the puzzle pieces that add up to a person snoring, it could be a sign of a bigger issue, known as obstructive sleep apnea, or OSA. Now, not every snorer has this condition, even if their snoring is chronic, but OSA could be a serious condition that should be addressed by a medical professional. And now on to question two. Simi asks, Dear Blocko, how can some people fall asleep anywhere? Well, from a medical perspective, it sounds like you're referring to something called narcolepsy. Narcolepsy is a sleep disorder where people have overwhelming daytime drowsiness, leading them to fall asleep anywhere, at any time, during any activity. There isn't a cure yet for narcolepsy, but treatments like certain medications and lifestyle changes can help with the symptoms. But maybe you're just talking about people who seem to be able to treat any surface as a comfy bed. It might just be that that person has suffered from overexhaustion. They might be really, really tired. I'm pretty sure that's why most parents can sleep almost anywhere. And now it's time for questions about my world. Pigmaster101 asks, Dear Animator, where is Blocko's secret stash of waffles? Hey, this is Dear Blocko. You got the wrong show. Wait a minute. Animator, don't you dare show them my hiding spot. Don't you try and rainbow swipe to another scene. Hey, you can't have any waffles. Okay? They're for the gnomes. Don't tell anyone they live here, okay? I trust you. Second question up, Bats Games asks, Dear Blocko, do you think that Rhombus is fully healed yet? Yeah, Rhombus is actually fully healed. After he got over his glitch monster infection, he had a new lease on life. He's been wearing leather jackets, learning new skills, and he finally finished his perfect chicken nugget recipe. He's pretty much killing it. Rhombus, are you wearing 17 leather jackets? Dang, that's so cool. So do you have any questions about my world and your world? Let me know in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. Want to watch even more DearBlocko? Check out the previous one we did. Some people even claim to have gone off the grid, at least to some extent. One option is to build a tiny home off the grid without public power, water, natural gas, or telephone lines. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.